Today we are going to discuss about Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. So let's start with the figure of the Babcock-Wilcox boiler. So we are going to discuss in details of each and every parts of the Babcock-Wilcox boiler, and also we are going to see how the steam will generate from the water in the Babcock-Wilcox boiler. This is another image of the Babcock-Wilcox boiler. It is a little bit difficult to draw the figure of the Babcock-Wilcox boiler in the examination. I have discussed in my previous video of how to draw the Babcock-Wilcox boiler, so you can refer it. I am going to show the drawing of Babcock-Wilcox boiler with the little bit fast speed. But I have actually discussed in my earlier video of how to draw the Babcock-Wilcox boiler, where I have drawn the same figure with step by step and explain the function of the parts also. Already we have drawn this figure. Now first point, that is the features. So it is a multitubular boiler. So you can see the number of tubes are there. Externally fired boiler, because of the fire is outside of this boiler shell. The boiler shell is in horizontal position, so it is called as the horizontal boiler. It is high pressure boiler, stationary boiler, it can't move from one place to another place. Natural circulation of water and steam, that is due to the density difference. Forced circulation of air and hot gases, because of here it is provided the chimney, and so that the pressure force that is actually created to move the flue gases. Solid as well as liquid fuel fired, and water tube boiler, because water is inside the tubes and outside flue gases, and that's why it is called as water tube boiler. Now next, function of parts. So I am going to describe over here major parts only. Boiler shell, this is the boiler shell used to accumulate the steam from the water. Tubes, water tubes. Inclined tubes are used to bring natural circulation of water, because of you can see over here with the help of the density difference, automatically it will move in the upward direction. Headers are provided with holes to support the water tubes. Header, that means downtake header and uptake headers. Next, baffles are placed for creating sine wave form of hot gases to increase more heat transfer, and that you can see sine wave form of the flue gases. Grate, coal is introduced to furnace grate through the fire hole. So this is the grate and this is the fire hole. So through the fire hole the coal is provided. Ash pit is provided to collect ash produced by combustion of the fuels. Superheater, name itself indicate, it is used to convert the superheated steam from the wet steam. Now the important boiler mountings. First, pressure gauge, it measures the pressure of the steam inside the boiler. Second, safety valve, it blows off the extra steam when the steam pressure inside the boiler reaches above safety level. Third, water level indicator, the position of the water level in the boiler shell is indicated by the water level indicator. So with the help of this water level indicator you can see the water level inside the boiler shell. Fourth one, stop valve, or sometimes it is called as steam stop valve, is used to transfer steam to the desired location when it is required. And fifth one, blow off coke, it is used to blow off the settle down impurities, mud and sediments present in the boiler water with the help of this mud box. Now working. First, water is supplied to the boiler through the feed check valve. Due to the gravity, water passes through the header, and so that the water tubes, that is filled with the water completely. Now the coal, that is placed at the grate through the fire hole. So the flue gas is produced by firing of coal. Produced flue gases start flowing around the tubes, and this sine waves is due to the baffles as shown in figure. Water comes down through the downtake heater and enters the tubes, where water is heated by the flue gases coming from the furnace. Next, due to the heating of water, density of water decreases inside the tubes, and so that it will automatically moves upward in the water tubes. At higher portion of the tubes, the temperature is higher than the lower portion of the tubes, and that you can understand from the figure, because of the higher portion of the tubes that is very near to the furnace, and so that low density of water is gradually converted into steam, moves into the drum through uptake heater into the boiler shell, and thus the water and steam cycle is repeated. Steam flows in the superheated tubes, where it is further heated and is supplied through the steam stop valve where it is required. At lowest point of the downtake heater, mud is collected by the mud box and is removed with the help of the blowcock. Now, dimensions and specification of the Babcock Wilcox boiler. Shell diameter, that is 1.5 meter, length of the shell, that is 8 meter, steam generation capacity, that is 40,000 kg per hour, efficiency is approximately 70%, maximum pressure of the steam is 40 bar. So this is the typical specification of the Babcock Wilcox boiler, but it can be little bit varying. Advantages. First, steam generation capacity is high compared to other boiler. Draft loss is minimum compared to other boilers. Easy replacement of defective tubes. Overall efficiency is higher than other fire tube boiler. It can use solid as well as liquid fuel. Now, the applications of the Babcock Wilcox boiler. First, it is used for power generation in small size thermal power plant. It is also used to generate steam for heating process. Thanks, my dear friends. Press the like button to appreciate this video.